Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company, and welcome to our September 7th, 8th, and 9th Premier Firearms Auction, our second premier sale of 2018, and what an auction it's going to be. I don't have to get into the names, and I won't get into the genres. Well, I have to. How about Robert M. Lee, Mac McCroskey, Bob Berryman, Alan Coors? I'll just name a few. Regardless of what your interest is, Colts, Winchesters, U.S. military, German military, Class 3s, it is here. It is here in force. And if anything exemplifies what this September sale is all about, it is this table right in front of me. If you are a fan of 19th, 20th century U.S. military firearms, military vehicles, well, I know where you should be in September. Rock Island Auction Company, we cut our teeth on selling U.S. military. That is what we specialize in and have since done well in other areas. But U.S. military has always been Rock Island Auction Company's bread and butter. And I don't know of a finer offering of U.S. military small arms than this September. And here's why. Headlined, of course, by the Alan Coors Collection. So, to be able to have this opportunity, I mean, I don't know of a museum that you could go to and see the variety and see the depth and see the condition that exists here. And we'll start on my left. We'll kind of do a, we'll do an evolutionary mix and then talk about some of this rare stuff. But hey, why not start in 1892 with a Ronaldo A. Carr inspected Colt Cavalry single action 7.5-inch classic gun, but a really beautiful example. And then let's transition into the 20th century and talk about some of this rarity as U.S. military standard issue sidearms. How about a 1900 U.S. Navy sight safety, one of only 250 in the first contract, but look at the condition. And that's what you're going to start seeing down the line here. You want to talk about further rarity, one of 200 O2 militaries. Again, look at the condition. And then, boy, if you study 1911s, obviously, in the evolution of the semi-automatic pistol, how about a 1909, one of 23, a true icon, a true legend, the holy grail, 1909, 45 ACP test pistol, one of only 23. These would eventually lead to Colt getting the contract for the 1911, subsequent 1911A1, which we have. This is serial number 20, courtesy of the Robert Farrow collection, and then one of two Singers in the sale. You did hear that correctly, one of two Singers in the sale. The other one is a spectacular fresh find consigned right out of the family it's one of the most historic guns we've ever sold, and this is prototype number 3. I'll flip it around here for you so we can see it. We sold this gun 5 or 6 years ago. But if you watch the U.S. military market, if you watch the 1911 market, the 1911A1 market, you know what these are doing. This is prototype number 3. It's a well-known gun. To really drill deeper and talk about the depth of this sale, how about experimental 03 Bolo bayonet right behind it, a clandestine Sedgley fist pistol. You've probably seen or read about some of those, but one of very few at U.S. Navy marked. How about a U.S. M40 Remington 700? And, you know, they're not rare for what they are, but they're rare for what they are. And if you want to find one, and that's how a lot of this stuff is, if you pass, wait, when will you get another opportunity? If you pass and don't put your hand up in the air come September 7th, 8th, or 9th, when will you have another opportunity to own one of the finest M40 U.S. sniper rifles? Right behind it, just a really iconic, cool example of an 1897 Trent shotgun. And why not throw it in the mix with such a beautiful display here? And then, so that was the common stuff. We'll transition from the 1897 Trent shotgun, and now we're going to get into, believe it or not, some of the rare stuff. if you're tracking what we went through, this is the rare stuff. And talk about the Holy Grail. Talk about an icon. Talk about reading something in a book and never having an opportunity to see it in person. But here is a John Garin primer actuated prototype circa 1923. While he's developing his design, one of, I believe, 25 produced, and one of about 2 or 3 known in private hands. And again, I'll say what I said before. When will you have another opportunity to, let alone see it, but raise your hand and own something of this importance? Right underneath it, How about serial number 19,059 M1 gas trap? A beautiful example, the finest as far as we're concerned, the finest known example in private hands, all original. Right underneath it, how about serial number 33, 1892, Craig? And then right underneath it, 1923 Thompson prototype semi-automatic rifle. We sold one in the Brotherton collection, and if those aren't the coolest rifles you've seen, please point me in the right direction. And again, this, you know, you've seen, we started in 1890, we went to 1892, and then you've seen an evolutionary mix of U.S. military arms throughout the 20th century. And I got to tell you, the European military is just as good, believe it or not. But so are the Colts, Winchesters, Class 3s, sporting arms, you name it. It's here in quantity and quality. So if you desire to own the best, if you've considered firearms as a hard asset, alternative investment, U.S. military, particularly World War II, is a really hot genre. And you won't be able to improve this stuff. And as we know, with some of the icons of the 19th century American guns, they get put in collections and they're gone. And that's the case, and that's how a lot of this stuff has been. And you know, here it is. And again, it's headlined by the Alan Coors Collection, the 63rd president of the National Rifle Association of America, an absolute gentleman and a world-class collector. And he has a wonderful eye, and obviously this is a testament to what he's built. So thank you, Mr. Coors, for the opportunity here. And oh, by the way, you know, we're talking about the stuff that's on this table, and this is only what we could fit on an 8-foot table. I don't have serial number 1 million M1 Grand presented to John Guerin by Springfield Armory. I don't have the Japanese Grand prototype. I don't have the, of course, not U.S. military, but experimental, the Farquhar Hill experimental semi-automatic rifle. It is endless. And if you are interested in military weapons, whether it's domestic or foreign, this is the sale to be at. So if you've ever considered becoming one of our sales, we can't encourage it more. Again, September 7th, 8th, and 9th, 2018. Don't forget about our preview date, September 6th. It's a lot of fun. It's open to the public. We do a party in the evening. For more information on the auction, visit our website, www.rockallenauction.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hope to see you in September.